It is true that it is a natural disease in the wild stocks. However, what happens with this on the salmon farms is that because the fish are so unnaturally packed into these open cages, the diseases in the cages are amplified. And so in the case of an outbreak like this, there would be 60 billion particles of pathogens entering per hour, entering the water. So any wild salmon that are swimming past that farm are going to be swimming through all of this disease.
It's very upsetting and very worrying to hear about the issues with the salmon, and it's something that, you know, by the time we know, we maybe are paying the price. So I think we just have to be so vigilant on these things. We have to be. I don't think we have a choice.
In my eyes, it just confirms what we have, you know, thought of salmon farming for quite a while, namely that it affects the local ecosystems in a negative way. You know, it leads to a decline in the Pacific wild salmon population, and of course, it's a scandal that it leads to diseases in the salmon that is being sold, you know, for the end consumers in supermarkets.
Well, it's pretty obvious that it doesn't belong here, the way it's done. I personally don't want to be extremist and say that we can't have fish farm at all, but the way it's done right now is absolutely outrageous. And there's simple things that can be done to start that wouldn't involve too much money, I would say. First of all, the Atlantic species doesn't belong in the Pacific Ocean. That's number one. And number two, the pen where the fish are held needs to be, I'd say, stronger and make sure that they can't get out of their pen. But I think if we have choice, it would be better out of the ocean, obviously. It doesn't belong and it doesn't make sense to grow many fish like this. Of course, there's going to be disease.